One of the coolest features you can use is Format Painter. So if you go over here and hover your mouse over it, it gives you contextual help. So you can always just, you know, take your time and read how to use each of these tools. And you can go to Tell Me More to find more information. So let's see how we can use it. For example, I like the title and I would like to keep this formatting and replicate it somewhere else. Then you go to Format Painter. And now you can see the mouse has a little brush over it, and you can go with the paintbrush over whatever you need to format. So say I want to format this selection A12 to J12, and I get the title. Okay, but that's not what I want, so let me just undo. Now let's see how we can apply the Format Painter multiple times. So say we like this blue background and the font and size and everything, so the whole formatting. And you double click the Format Painter, and now with it you can go multiple times. So I can go and just play like that. So you can see how useful this Format Painter can be, and also fun. So if you try, for example, let me push Escape to exit out of it. Sometimes it helps you with the numbers. Let's say if we need to have percent style with one decimal place, I can just, you know, take the format of one of those numbers. So click it, double click on Format Painter, and then I can just go over where supposedly I have that format I need. So let's go like that, and let's go like that, and as you can see, it's very quickly. Okay, I'm going to undo everything. So we go over here and we just undo. Now let's see if we want to try to move things around. Can we do that in Excel? And yes, you can. You make your selection and just drag it from the borders. Doesn't matter which borders, you can go in all directions, and then you move it where you need it. You're going to use a lot of copying and pasting, so let's give it a try. You can make a selection, and then you can use Control C to copy, Control X to cut. You can right click and you have the options cut and copy. Push Escape. You can go to cut and copy over here. So let's go ahead and do Control C to copy, and I'm going to paste it somewhere here, Control V. Now when you paste, you have many options. So you can paste formulas, you can paste together the number formatting, you can paste and keep the source formatting, you can keep, so just go over all the options in here. So no borders, I had borders before, now I don't. Then you can paste only the values. That's something that is used when you don't want to have the formatting, you don't want to have the formulas anymore, you just want to keep the values. Then you can paste it even as a link. So if I paste it as a link, and if I go ahead now and I change something here, it changes in the link. Okay, so let me just undo. And let me try one more time. So Control C and then Control V. And then you can paste it to the picture. So this is really a picture, and you have picture tools and format tab, so you can play with your picture and make it how you want. And let's undo. Let's try one more option, Control V again. And I'm going to see a linked picture. So that's even cooler. So if I go ahead and I change the numbers here, instead of 15%, I put 20%, then the sale price should change, and it changes also in my picture. If I make a selection again and Control C, I can use Pay Special. And in here you have Transpose. Let's see what it does. You need first to, you know, to have a place where you paste the information. And then let's try the Transpose. Actually is also, it should be here in one of the options here. So let's hover over the options. And that's the T. You can also use a shortcut. Transpose will simply switch the layout. If this was in a column, now it's in a row. Let me show you something. If you try to delete this, if you just push delete on the keyboard, this is what happens. The content is gone, but not the formatting. You actually need to use from the Home tab, there is this eraser. So you can clear the formats, or if you have contents also, you can just hit clear all. You can even do more with copy and paste. So let me show you a cool trick. If you have some numbers like 1, 2, 3, and I want to multiply the 2020 10% here, I want to multiply by each of these numbers. So let's see how we can do this. We can copy, Control C, and then I position my mouse where I need to paste. And I'm going to use from the paste button, you can use paste special. And you can choose multiply. And let's see what happens. So I want to multiply 20 by 1, 20 by 2, and 10 by 3. And it looks like it worked.